Greetings. This video is part 11 in a series. I'm examining and reviewing all of the verses which Islam tries to claim refer to Muhammad. I have documented the claims by the author of the Quran in Surah 7, 157 and 158, and Surah 61, 6, which purport to confirm Muhammad is mentioned in the Torah and Bible. And I have shown the desperate situation Islam finds itself in, because these claims cannot be confirmed. So Islam has no way to prove Muhammad was not a liar. In the Gospels, the primary claim Islam attempts to make to insert Muhammad is the claim he is the Comforter, the Holy Spirit. In part 10, I thoroughly covered John 14, where Jesus began to reveal and teach about the Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, the Holy Ghost. Let's continue with John 15. Jesus begins with some pretty incredible statements. John 15:1, I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Can you imagine a mere prophet, a mere Rasul, making such a claim? Jesus did not say, God is the true vine. Nor in this place did Jesus say, my message is the true message. Jesus said, I am the true vine, meaning the source of life for the leaves and branches. John 15:2, every branch in me that bears not fruit he takes away, and every branch that bears fruit he purges it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself except it abide in the vine, no more can you except you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He that abides in me and I in him, the same brings forth much fruit, for without me you can do nothing. That sounds a whole lot like Jesus' relationship with God the Father. He that abides in me and I in him. And Jesus continues teaching some deep and mysterious truths, but that is not the study of this video. In John 15, Jesus only mentions the Comforter in passing, reaffirming what he has already said. John 15:26, but when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of Truth which proceeds from the Father, he shall testify of me. And in this statement by Jesus, there are five details we must pay attention to if we respect what Jesus said. But when the Comforter comes, one, whom I will send unto you, two, from the Father, three, even the Spirit of Truth, four, which proceedeth from the Father, five, he shall testify of me. One, whom I will send unto you. Jesus repeats that he is sending the Comforter. This makes perfect sense using the Christian definitions and interpretation, but Islam has no hope of making sense of this phrase. If Jesus sent the Comforter, Muhammad, and Islam claims Allah sent Muhammad, then Jesus is Allah. Jesus, again, talking to the disciples, repeats the Comforter is coming to them when he says, unto you, not unto those who follow you. Again, this makes perfect sense using the Christian definitions and interpretation. The Holy Spirit came on the day of Pentecost, only 50 days after Jesus was crucified. But Islam has no hope of making sense of this phrase because Muhammad did not come to the disciples. Muhammad was not born for almost 600 more years. All the disciples were dead and long gone. To claim Muhammad was the Comforter, you have to ignore the promise Jesus made to the disciples. The undeniable implication of Islam's claim is that Jesus lied to his disciples and left them comfortless. 2. From the Father. Again and again, Jesus referred to the Father, meaning his Father, and it is undeniable Jesus meant Almighty Jehovah God. But followers of Muhammad only want some of the words Jesus spoke. They want and need the word comforter because it appears to be an ambiguity to which they can attach Mohammed. But words like father are literally invisible to them. People in Islam ignore the word father, making themselves literally ignorant. The fascinating thing is the Quran condemns those who only accept and follow some of God's word. Surah 285, do you believe in one part of the book and deny another part of it? Those of you who act thus shall be rewarded with disgrace in this world and with severe punishment on the day of resurrection. God is never unaware of what you do. The Quran curses you, O Muslim, for ignoring parts of the Word of God, the Bible. Even the Spirit of Truth. Jesus clarifies who the Comforter is by explicitly naming him. The Comforter is the Spirit of Truth. I find it amazing that Islam claims one of Allah's 99 names is Al-Haq, the Truth. And Jesus essentially says the Comforter is the Spirit of Al-Haq, the Spirit of God Himself. Jesus did not say a prophet who is truthful, but Islam and men like Didat change the words of God that Jesus spoke. When Islam does this, it proves to me they have more regard for Muhammad than for Almighty God, which proceedeth from the Father. Now this is an interesting choice of words. Proceeds from God is different than was sent by God. Anyone can send someone without the sent coming from the sender. Or do you wish to claim, O Muslim, that every prophet came directly from heaven? Proceeds from God means to come from heaven and from God. Proceeds from God is different than was sent by God. But Islam tries very hard to read this phrase as sent by Allah. The best way to understand this phrase is examine multiple translations. The Spirit of Truth who goes out from the Father, He will come to you from the Father, the Spirit of Truth who proceeds from the Father, the Spirit of Truth who comes from the Father, the Spirit of Truth who goes forth from with the Father, the Spirit of Truth which proceedeth from the Father, even the Spirit of Truth which proceedeth from the Father. Notice, which is used, not who, meaning a human is not even indicated. O Muslim, where is God? Where is your Allah? Is He in Mecca? Is He in the Kaaba? Jesus said the Spirit of Truth would come from the Father, proceed from the Father. That means the Comforter had to come from being with Allah or God. O Muslim, do you believe that Muhammad came from paradise, from heaven with Allah, and proceedeth from the Father? And that is a problem with Islam's claim that Muhammad came from Allah in heaven. But the Christian explanation makes perfect sense. The Holy Spirit of God is with God in heaven. As God, the Holy Spirit could be both on earth and in heaven before He was sent by Jesus. And as Jesus taught in John 14, the difference would be the Holy Spirit living in them. Point 5, He shall testify of Me. The Comforter has a very specific purpose. He will testify, confirm, and speak about Jesus. Aha! The Muslim says, Muhammad spoke of Jesus. Unfortunately, most of what Muhammad said was false and baseless. I think Muhammad was correct that Jesus was Mary's son, but everything else is in doubt. The biggest problem is that Muhammad did not confirm what Jesus said. In fact, Muhammad's message implies that Jesus was a liar and a blasphemer for claiming to be the Son of God. No rational person can think that fulfills Jesus' intent and meaning when He revealed the Comforter, who would testify of Jesus and be a witness for Jesus. But when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth which proceeds from the Father, he shall testify of me. After examination, Mohammed simply does not fit the details of the description Jesus gave. Not surprisingly, this reference and description of the Comforter is largely ignored by Islamic storytellers. It does not appear to benefit their desperate need to insert Mohammed into the Bible, the New Testament. And all the common problems exist for this reference. No mention of Prophet, or Ahmad, Mohammed, or unlearned. I hope you are paying attention, both Christians and Muslims. Muslims, it is critical that you learn the real meaning Jesus taught, and that you listen and accept the true Injil. Christians, it is critical that you know and hold on to the truth, because the errors and frauds of Islam are too numerous to dismiss. Well, okay, once you know that every claim from Islam is a lie, it really is pretty easy to dismiss every claim. But Christians, you must come to that conclusion after lots of study and with evidence to support your determination. Otherwise, one day, a new lie might come from Islam that you cannot immediately refute. For example, a man from Islam claiming he is the Isa, the Lord Jesus, returned, and he will not have marks of crucifixion. You need to know Islam is a lie. It is not the truth, or such a lie will fool even the elect. In part 12, I'll get back to examining John 16. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.